Hi, welcome back to part two of traveling to Niagara Falls and things to do, especially as a single mom taking her kid out to experience it for ourselves. We booked a tour, and part two of the tour is it took us over to the other side where we got to stand and see kind of the horseshoe area. It was really neat. There was so many beautiful rainbows. We had a little bit of a break right outside, and then we walked over to another half where we were able to get ready to go experience the Cave of the Winds. It was really neat to see how the falls really kind of come together from so many different parts of the water. So the view is just beautiful and spectacular. Just below is the Cave of the Winds. We were able to get our tickets and they just let us go, which I thought was nice to not have to be followed around by people. We just got to experience it at our own time. We didn't have to listen to people talking the whole time. It was kind of like we were on our own, which is what I wanted. So here we are climbing up to go to the Hurricane Deck, which was a huge bucket list of mine as well. Absolutely phenomenal. I'll probably post another video of just the Hurricane Deck itself, but it is so incredibly powerful. I had to hold onto my son's glasses so they wouldn't get knocked off of his face. And this was one of my highlights of the entire trip. This is a definite must-do. And most tour guides, you can book all of these excursions, and they just take you to all of them afterwards. Of course, we got trinkets, and once we got back to the hotel, we hung out in the jacuzzi. See part three for more.